10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Ignition. And liftoff of Falcon's first East Coast polar launch, Hola Argentina.
We're now 40 seconds in the flight. Falcon 9 has taken off. It's cleared the tower, and we're currently throttling down to prepare for maximum Q. That's the point of maximum aerodynamic pressure. It's at 1 minute 12 seconds.
Vehicle is supersonic. Vehicle has reached maximum aerodynamic pressure.
You've heard it. We've reached max Q. At this point, the loads in the vehicle become less and less as the atmosphere gets thinner. We're now able to throttle those Merlin engines back up. And at its maximum power, like right now, the vehicle consumes more than 700 gallons of fuel per second. All is looking good with our first stage's trajectory. The next couple events, there are five events, one after another. First, our main engine cuts off on our first stage. The stages will separate. Our first stage will then flip around to begin its landing attempt. The second stage's Merlin vacuum engine will ignite for second engine start one. The first stage's boost back burn will start. It's one of three burns to help us land. They occur one after another in about 15 seconds. And this is that first polar orbit. If the clouds, if you can see through the clouds here, you'll see some unique views that you haven't seen from Falcon 9 over Florida.
And we have Miko.
Stage separation confirmed.
And the ignition.
All right, all of those events happen successfully one after another. This boost back burn, it'll last about 40 seconds. And so you see it on the left-hand side of the screen. On the right-hand side, you will see our second stage carrying those three satellites to orbit. And coming up next in about 20 seconds, that boost back burn will end, and then we'll have our fairing deployment.
Stage one, boost back, shut down.
All right, one of those first landing burn, the boost back burns has successfully ended. Our two fairing halves will now jettison to expose the satellites to space. And you see the first stage has already been in a turnaround, and you can see the nitrogen from our attitude control system helping guide it back.
Fairing separation confirmed.
There you see our two fairing halves have jettisoned. You can even see them in the background there on our MBAC engine, and you can see them from land too. It'll take us some time to get those to come back down. We'll keep you posted on the update.
We are T plus 4 minutes and 13 seconds into flight. Everything is looking great for tonight's mission. On the right-hand side of your screen is a view of our second stage, specifically its Merlin vacuum engine. We also call it MVAC engine for short. It's currently in the first of its two planned, first and only planned MVAC burn. The first burn should last for about another 4 minutes.
Stage one entry burn startup.
And three Merlin engines have relit and are currently slowing the first stage down before it hits those dense parts of the atmosphere. Second stage on the right-hand side of your screen is continuing to perform as expected.
Stage one, entry burn shutdown.
And that is our second burn completed. And as we mentioned earlier, we are going to be attempting to recover this booster back at land on landing zone one. The first stage has one more burn left.
Stage one, FTS is saved.
That is the landing burn. It begins just before we touch down and provides the booster with a soft descent before we land.
Stage one, transonic.
You can see the Cape getting closer and closer. What a cool view. The first stage is passing through the cloud layers right now.
Stage one, landing burn startup.
And here comes Falcon 9 attempting its fourth landing.
Stage one, landing leg deploy.
And you could not ask for a better landing than that. Falcon 9 has landed once again. That is number four for this first stage booster and the 58th overall of an orbital class rocket. What a way to start off tonight's mission.
Solcom separation confirmed.
All right, you've seen it, we heard it. Successful deployment of that Salcom 1B satellite. And as a reminder, this satellite and Salcom 1A satellite's goal is to gather soil moisture.